That your spirit gives us the power, Lord God, to do what it is that we thought was impossible, Lord God. Your spirit gives us the power to love, Lord God. Your spirit gives us the power to forgive, Lord God. Your spirit gives us the power to conquer, Lord God. Your spirit gives us the power to breathe. Your spirit gives us the power to live, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we decree that we declare, Heavenly Father, that this service on today will be an amazing service, Lord God. We thank you in advance for the lives that will be changed, God. We thank you in advance for the souls that will be saved, Heavenly Father. For your word says that if you be lifted up, God, you'll draw all men unto you, Heavenly Father. And so we lift up your name right now. We lift up your name right now. We give you the glory right now, God. We thank you, Heavenly Father. We ask you, Lord, to bless this place right now. Sanctify this place right now, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord God, for being the example, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord God, for walking like you. We thank you, Lord God, for talking like you. We thank you, Lord God, for believing like you, Heavenly Father, that we can do anything, that nothing is impossible with you, God. And right now, Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, for a special blessing on the mothers on today, Lord God. We thank you that you gave them the heart, Lord God, to love, Lord. You gave them the heart, Lord God, to protect, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Heavenly Father. We ask you to cover them right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We ask you to provide for them right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to lift them up right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And Father God, we just want to tell you, Lord God, that we believe and we decree and we declare that it is already done in your son's matchless name, Jesus Christ. So we all said amen and amen.
Your name up. glory to God. We lift your name up.
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 Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Come on, help us say it. We lift your name.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Glory to God.
This song.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Glory to God.
Put your hands together for fervent worship. Come on, everybody, lift your voice in the room. Lift your voice in the room. Oh, come on, come on. Lift your voice in the room. Lift your voice in the room, yeah. We serve an amazing God, yeah. Come on, we serve an amazing God, oh. So let's magnify His name. Let's magnify His name this morning. Let's magnify His name this morning. Come on. Come on. Invite Him in. 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 Invite in your King. Invite in your King. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's lift up His name this morning. Come on. Come on, everybody clap your hands. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, lift your voice. Come on in the room. Yeah, yeah.
There is power in the name.
There is power in the name. Call the name Jesus. Yeah, call the
name Jesus. Yeah, call the name Jesus. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. At the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and some proclaim, Jesus, oh Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God. One more time, Jesus, oh Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim that you are Jesus. You are Jesus. You are Savior. You are Lord. And you are God. You're the only living God. Oh, you're the only living God. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, as the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim that you are Jesus. Oh, Jesus, you are Savior and you are Lord. And you are God. Come on, lift your voice.
Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You can be seated if you can. Good morning, good morning, and God bless you. And yes, we are here calling on that mighty name of Jesus. For if it's not for Jesus, we wouldn't even be here this morning. Amen? So God bless you. God bless you. And welcome to this worship service at Fervent Prayer Outreach Ministries. For all of you here in the sanctuary and for those who are viewing us via the internet on this morning, God bless you. And to all the mothers, happy Mother's Day. Amen? Thank God for our mothers, those who are still here with us, and those who have gone on to be with the Lord, such as my own. And I thank God for her. Amen? I can't imagine what kind of woman I would be, first of all, without God, and then without the strong woman of God who raised me. Amen? And I thank God for her. Amen? Her name was Mary Rose. Never forget, Mom. God bless you. God bless you. And we thank God for being in the sanctuary on today. And this is a good day. This is a beautiful day, rain and all. And we thank God for that. And we're going to continue to worship our Lord and Savior right now by worshiping the Lord in our giving. Amen? It is a blessing. That's right. Clap. It is a blessing to give into the kingdom of God. God has done so much for us, Fervent Prayer. We are still here in spite of all the trials, tribulations, and troubles that have gone on in our lives, because many are the afflictions of the righteous, but we're still here. Amen. God has seen us through it all, and he's seeing us through it all. And we thank him for that, and we want to show our appreciation by being obedient to his word. Here in the sanctuary, ushers are giving out envelopes to those who are here to give their tithes and offerings. And also you who are viewing us via the internet, there are many ways that you can still give in the comfort of your own home or wherever you might be. They will put on the screen there that we can give electronically in three different ways. The church has a Cash App. There's also Text for Give. And we also can download a Giplify app on your smartphone and give that way. And besides that, if you're here in the sanctuary, we have a debit credit card machine there in the back to my right, your left. And also cash and checks work just as well as they always did. Amen. Until they tell us we can't write checks again, Fervent Prayer, I'm going to still be writing my checks. Amen. Pastor calls me old-fashioned, but hey, it still works. It still works. And you get all your money. Nobody's charging a fee. So we thank God for that. And whatever way you have, God has put upon your heart to give this morning, be obedient to the word of God and give into the house of the Lord. Because you know we do many outreaches here at Fervent Prayer, feeding the hungry. We have our food pantry open now. We hire the youth with Clean for Green. Amen. So this is all, and then many other outreaches as well. So please, whatever the Lord is putting on your heart this morning, be it your tithes, which he has commanded us to give, or an offering, do that in obedience to the word of God and see if you won't be blessed. Because as we know, no one can beat God's giving. Amen. No one, none of us. So if you prepared your offering here thus far, we're going to stand, please, and do repeat our giving affirmation that you see there on the screen. Because we are appreciating God for what he is doing for us. So please repeat after me. I believe that I receive God's best on my seed sown today. I believe that because I am a giver, God is raising up others who will use their power, their influence, and their authority to help me. Therefore, I believe that I am abundantly supplied spiritually, physically, and financially. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Please follow directions of the ushers for those of you here in the sanctuary. And while you are doing your giving, and we're going to be having announcements immediately after this, but there was one announcement I just wanted to mention because they didn't have time to put it on the announcements, and that is an event that's going to be happening with Chosen Vessels at the end of the month, the last Saturday of the month, which is the 29th, that's right. We're going to be having Chosen Vessels, and this is for the ladies of the house, a tea and painting party, amen. We haven't done that in a while. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're going to have a sign-up table in the entryway of the church here after service on today. And it's only going to cost $40 per person to be a painter and to bring home your masterpiece. Amen. We're going to be having a lot of refreshments, healthy refreshments as well. Amen. And good things to eat, as well as tea, of course, while you're doing your masterpiece. And we're going to be doing that with the help of Minosa and Masterpiece. It's a minority-owned business here in Indianapolis, and she is awesome. Amen. She does wonderful work, and she's going to show you how to bring out the best in your painting. So please sign up. We already have almost half of our limit for sign-ups right now, so please don't wait till the last minute, because as you know, we're doing it in one of the other buildings, and we have to be, you know, cautious of COVID and do our separations accordingly. So there is limited seating. So sign up at the end of service and pay your fee, or let us know when, and we'll make sure that you have a seat. God bless you.
Hey, FBC family. Check out how we're bringing in the month of May at Fervent Prayer. Pastor Jackson has your mornings on lock with First Hour Prayer Live. On Facebook weekdays at 6:30 a.m. and 7:15 a.m. Keep your eyes open for our small groups live every week on Facebook. Celebrity Saints, Mondays at 7 p.m. And Total Man with Pastor Jackson every second Tuesday of the month at 7 p.m. Go like, follow, and leave a comment for us. We can't wait to connect with you. Last week, we debuted our newest series, The Holy Spirit. If you missed any of these services, catch them on replay on any of the platforms below. Worship with us online or in person. Sundays at 10 a.m. And Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Keep your eyes open for these upcoming events at FBCC. Woman-to-woman discussion channel, an extension of Chosen Vessels, brings to you the character of a noble woman event, taking place on May 12th at 7 p.m. at the Fervent Prayer Church. Sisters Tierra Mitchell, Nichelle Smith, Cookie DeLosa, and Courtney Vaughn will be covering the topic of knowing your worth. Ladies, you don't want to miss this.
FPC's food pantry is back every first Saturday of the month from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. And every fourth Wednesday of the month, starting on May 26th, from 5:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. On Friday, May 28th, FPC will celebrate the fourth anniversary of First Hour Prayer. Celebrate with us, live or in person in the FPC worship space, beginning at 6 a.m. and concluding at 7:15 a.m. Refreshments will be served. The best way to get more information about our groups, events, and anything involving Fervent Prayer Ministries is through our app, available in the App Store and the Google Play Store. Pastor James William Jackson brings you his entire collection of books, The Gosha Anointing, How to Pray the Lord's Prayer, and The Power of the Prayer Meeting, available at jameswjacksonministries.com. If you or your family are in need of support in any way, please contact our member services team by phone at 317-665-8659 or by email at administrator@fpcindy.com.
My best memory I have of my mom is when we threw my big party for my 15th birthday.
I have a memory of me and my mom is when we had went to Kentucky King.
When we was playing in the pool and she splashed me.
Was when we went to Cincinnati because we had so much fun.
When we both got our nails done and went shopping because we got to spend more time together.
When we went to Sky Zone because Fresh is like, I'm not gonna jump. Then she started jumping when she started seeing me jump.
So there was this one time, I think it was my birthday, and we were at McDonald's, and everyone was singing happy birthday to me, but I cried. I don't know why, but my mom, she was there, and she was like comforting me and stuff, and she's like, it's okay, you don't have to cry. And then I was happy, and I think I ate my cake after, because I was happy birthday. So, yeah.
Probably at the time we went to Ohio for my brother's baseball game. It's my favorite memory because she did some things that made me laugh really hard and it was fun.
We went to Disneyland during summer and we just rode all the rides, ate a lot of food, had a lot of fun together.
It's probably when we were it was like my third birthday. We were goofing off. I hit my head on a slide, and I think we went inside and I had lots and lots of ice cream. We watched a movie and it was great.
The time that I was most proud of my mom is when she decided to go back to college to become a RN.
When she told me she wanted to make her own business.
Was when she became a chief of staff to what this church.
I was most proud of my mom when she became a pastor, when she got her pastor license.
When she allowed me to dance on this good and wonderful team.
Oh, so there was this one time she was like sick and she had these like stones in her gallbladder, and so she had like no chance of living, but she like pushed through it while she was in her surgery and she survived.
I was most proud of my mom when she got ordained to become a minister in December 2019.
The time when I was most proud of my mom was when my grandma was yelling at her and she was being really mean. And my mom did not yell back, and she just stood there and took it like a champ.
When she put a roof over my head and told me to keep trying.
I was most proud of my mom. She was faced with a difficult decision, and she didn't take the easy road, but took the hard road and made the tough decision that was better for me and our family.
And now, let's get to worship.
glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Everybody say,
glory to the Lamb.
We sing,
glory to the Lamb.
We give all glory to the Lamb.
To the Lamb.
Yes, we sing,
glory,
glory to the
to
Lamb.
The Lamb.
And this is why. For he is
Alpha
and Omega.
Omega.
Forever,
forever,
forever is he.
He is he.
And he will reign forever,
forever.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy,
holy is he.
Is he.
So together let's sing glory,
glory
to the Lamb. Father, we sing tonight, glory,
glory,
glory to the Lamb.
To the Lamb.
We give all the glory,
glory
to the Lamb.
To the Lamb.
Jesus is his name. We give
glory.
Praise you, we magnify you, we glorify your holy name. You are King of Kings, you are Lord of Lords, you are the mighty God, and we bless you today. We thank you for this day that you have made. We worship you on today, oh Lord God. We thank you for our mothers on today. We thank you for women. We thank you for woman. We thank you and praise you, Father, for this day that you have made. And we ask that somebody would be saved today. Somebody would be healed. Somebody would be delivered. That this would not just be another worship service, but that this would be the beginning of days for somebody. And God, we give you all the praise and the glory and the honor for what you have done and for all that you promised to do. Be glorified in Jesus' name. Remain standing. Put those hands together one more time. Amen, amen, amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Well, we have a very special speaker on today. We thank God for her being here. Drove all the way, I think, from Gary today. Started out early this morning then. Yeah, so we thank God for you. She's a former deputy mayor of Gary, Indiana. And she has done tremendous things to boost the quality of life for all people, and especially black people. And we are so proud of her accomplishments. She's also a PK, and that's two letters for pastor's kid. And so she's going to bless us this morning. So even if she just give her testimony, I think that as she talks with you today, see, the Bible said that Jesus, the Bible says that Jesus' disciples said, did not our hearts burn within us as he opened to us the scriptures and talked with us by the way? And sometimes it's just good to have somebody talk with you. And as they talk, you might be going through something, and you would hear that they were able to get through it with the power of God. So I want you to give a good Indianapolis God bless you to Be Our Lane.
So much for coming to see me this morning to praise, worship. I am just going to sit and talk for a little while. It's not going to be long, just a testimony, hopefully to encourage. Firstly, to encourage. Maybe to give some folks caution about what could happen if you do certain things. So we're just going to go with it, and wherever he wants to go, that's where we're going. Y'all good with that? All right. So this is our women, no, this is our women's scripture, right? The virtuous woman. She's bad. So we always want to run to that. And we do, right? But for me, at least, I think for a long time, I read it in reverse. I read it the wrong way. I was chasing virtue. If you do this, 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 and that, then you get virtue. I call it the paper virtue. So I can give you my resume, and I'm gonna just tell you this just because I think it gives context to what we're talking about today. So grew up in Gary, love Gary, graduated from a visual and performing arts high school, which I loved, and went to a black college in Baltimore. So I'm away from mama, daddy, and church. And I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do. I was always the smart kid, right? I was kind of nerdy. I liked to read. I didn't play with dolls a lot. So I always had in my mind, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. And I did. I graduated from college in 3 years, and then I went to law school. I went to Harvard, and I got pregnant. Second year, and that's hard. It was hard because I had to come home and tell my mom and my dad, and the people at the church were gonna be looking at me. So I didn't know how to handle it. So you know what? I call it tuck. I tucked it and I pushed through, because that's what we do. So I pushed through, got done. Here's my baby. She's not a baby anymore, but in a sense we grew up together, right? Because I was a kid, I was 23. I was 23. I'm the oldest, but again, I was the nerd, so I didn't babysit my brother and sister a lot. I wanted to play or read my books. So I was just trying to figure out, you know, how to be a mom, what that means. I already knew I wasn't going to be like, you know, my mom, like prostrate on the floor, you know, prayer closet. And I figured she got that, right? Let me, who am I? Where am I going? And as a result, I've had a chance to do some wonderful things in life on paper. On paper. So I've lived and worked in Manhattan and LA and Beverly Hills and entertainment and Las Vegas and all these wonderful things, right? So I thought I had it. And I was kind of like this lady. We're gonna talk about her a little bit here. And it wasn't until, that's not true. If you listen, if you actually listen, you can hear. Don't do that. Go here, go there. It's that voice, right? But you have to listen. Because it's not going to beat you down. It's not going to yell at you. It's not going to command you do anything. It'll just, don't do that. Pass. Say no. Don't do that. But I am so goal-oriented, right? So I couldn't hear. I was just put something in front of me. If I decide this is what I'm going to do, there's nothing you or anybody else can do to prevent me from doing that. And so it wasn't until I was forced to have to hear. And that's all I could do, right? That's all, that it was nothing else, just basics, that I really started to, as I say, come into myself this late in life and try to learn how to live and how not to fight so hard to live, if that makes sense. Because we spend a lot of energy trying to make this down here perfect. Like, and I remember at one point I said to myself, you are fighting a losing battle. You know you're leaving here. Why are you working so hard to stay and to make it be how you want it to be while you're here? But you just get in that flow, right? That's what you do. That's what you do. So let's talk about her, and then I'm going to tell you a little bit more about my story. So who can find the virtuous woman? Her price is far above rubies. You know that. Let's talk a little bit about what she does. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax, and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant ship. She bringeth food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. She considereth the field, and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand, she planteth a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength. She strengthens her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She's up all night. Is anybody else tired reading about this? Reading about sis? She bad, but I'm tired reading about her. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hold her hands to the distaff. She stretches out her hand to the poor. Yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of snow for her household, for all of her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known at the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and delivereth girdles unto the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. She's not resting. Her children arise up and call her blessed, and her husband also, and he praiseth her. So you tell me, is all of this what makes her virtuous? All this stuff she's doing for everybody else? Because I want you to be clear about this, mothers. Out of those 10, 18 verses, two things did she do for herself. Everything else, She's making him look good. She's making them look good. She's taking care of the household staff. She's going for it, right? Hey, I'm not mad. This is bad. But this does not make her virtuous. Back at the top, it says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. She's already virtuous. Or she has to be. Because I'm going to tell you this. If you don't have it in you, if you're not living from the inside out, and you're thinking you're going to earn the virtue by doing all this stuff, you're not going to make it. You're doing it backwards. How do I know? Live my life that whole way. I can give you all of my resume. I did this, I did that, I've sat with every president you wanted to, all of that, wonderful, great. That does not make you virtuous, that does not bring you the peace. That's not it. But I didn't know, I had no idea. So at one point I was running the Illinois lottery. I was the head of the Illinois lottery. The new governor, Republican governor, who I didn't know, I'm in Gary now. At that time, I was running the Gary airport. He just found me somehow. I never met this man. He was a billionaire. I never met him, never talked to him before in my life. He says, hey, I've been reading about you in the Gary paper, really, from Chicago? Okay. And I want you to come and run the lottery. It's a $3 billion organization. We're in the middle of this big fight with, you know, some other people. I need you to get us out of this deal and do whatever. Me, I see goal. What? Do something that nobody else has done? I'm on it. Got it. I'm going for it. And I did. I worked day and night, and I can't even remember all of it. It's almost like a haze. But at one point, I'd been in a little car accident, little boom, hit and run, nothing big, and I had gotten sciatica. So I was doing yoga and Pilates and all of this, and my arm started to hurt. And so I figured, better go talk to the doctor and let her know that the sciatica is acting up again. So I go to the doctor. She's like, yeah, it's probably sciatica. Let's take a quick scan. She takes the scan. I'm out of here because I'm on my way back downstate to argue with the President of the Senate, Speaker of the House, all of this about our money, right? Our money at the lottery. And she calls me and she's like, turn around and come back right now. Turn around and come back right now. I have things to do. She's up at night. She doesn't sleep, right? Like all of this stuff. I don't have time to do this. I got to do this, that, and the other. No, come back. So I come back and she says, you know, when we were doing your x-ray or the scan, I saw something that we weren't looking for. We were looking at my arm, right? But the way that they did it, she saw a tumor at the base of my brain. And I was like, what? I had never been sick, right, in life. When I had her, I had a baby, stayed in the hospital for day two, then I'm back at it, right? I had an exam, actually, to take. And so I didn't process it. What I immediately thought was, okay, so what does that mean for what I need to get done? How do I, fix this? Can you fix this so I can get back to what I need to do? Because the governor is relying on me. My staff needs me. I gotta go. So what is this? To the point where the doctor, who, and y'all know HIPAA law, was like, do I need to call your mother? Because you're not understanding what I'm saying. Why are you talking to me about when I'm going to be done so you can go back to work? Do you understand what I'm saying? You have a tumor in your brain. And I was like, okay, well, so what do we do next? Like, let's get to it, right? So I took, after I got the diagnosis, I went back downstate. I didn't tell my mom. I didn't tell anybody. I did not tell anybody because I didn't want to talk about it. I had work to do. Went back downstate, got my work done, or at least a part of it. Then I talked to my family and said, okay, here's what we're going to do. They said they can remove it, we can do this, we can do that, blah, 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 right? And they're all looking at me like, are you serious right now? Y'all, I was so serious. I was so serious. I just wasn't processing it, right? I'm going for it. Like, you tell me, virtuous woman here, and you got to do all that stuff to get it. Okay, I'm on point number 7. I got 3 more points to make, right? So that's my mindset. So I have the surgery. I got it done quickly. It was benign. I was like, good, that's great. Now let's go. I'm on to the next thing. Like, oh, do you want to do this? The casino in the city wants to move off the water and move to the land. It's never been done 30 years in whole Indiana gaming history. It can never be done. My eyes light up. Really? Yes, let's do it. So I start working to do that. And of course, in the middle of that is life, right? Family relationships, romantic relationships, you know, interpersonal, like friendships, all that kind of stuff, right? But I tuck, right? So when something would come up, I'm just tucking it. I'll deal with it later. I'll deal with it later. Deal with it later. Until, again, maybe 3 years after the, 3 years, I'm counting with you, 3 years after the brain surgery, I go to the doctor again. Regular checkup, right? Again, let's hurry up. I got somewhere to be. Let's get this regular checkup. I'm a little bit late, but okay. And she's like, I feel a lump. And it's really big. And I'm thinking, well, how is it big? I just saw you a year ago, so what's going on? Again, I couldn't process. I did not tell anybody. I did not tell my daughter. I did not tell my mother. I didn't tell anybody. I was just thinking, how am I going to fix this? What do I do? What do I do? I kept working because I didn't know what to do, right? I mean, hard in the paint, like up at before the sun comes up and in the bed just before it comes up again kind of deal. And finally, it came to a point where my body had done it, had it, like, no. This is enough. So, okay, I'm doing chemo. I got to do chemo, this really rigorous regimen of chemo. And it had gotten to the point where literally I couldn't move. Like, I'm, you know. And so I would have to count the breaths to get up out of the bed, to go to the bathroom, to do anything. Okay. You can do it. Just breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe. I couldn't think about anything else. I couldn't consider anybody else. It was nothing else that mattered other than in that moment, breathing. I had to live. I had never been that quiet in my life here or had as much peace in my life. It's the craziest thing that I call it my peace bubble. Cancer was my peace bubble. Because it was just me, my ability to listen and hear and feel. And I, of course, didn't quite understand what was going on. Why is this happening to me? My mom is one of 11 kids, 6 women. Nobody else has breast cancer. Why would that happen to me? But I'm not a bitter type person. I didn't care. I was like, all right, well, whatever. It doesn't matter. So a girlfriend of mine from college said, you know what, you know, we have this like sister circle, we pray, and you know, I was kind of like, yeah, nah, I am a PK, Kojic PK, I don't let everybody pray for me, you not laying your hands on me, I wasn't with that. But she insisted, you gotta come, and you know, this group is different. So I said, okay. So it ended up just being me and this other woman. She didn't know anything about me, I just met her. And it wasn't all like deep or spooky or, you know, she wasn't asking me questions about myself. We were just, you know, got to meet each other and she's like, okay, let's pray. So we start praying. This lady said, there have been disappointments, failures, pain, loss, and you never dealt with them in your life. And you put it away, and it has now manifested physically in your body. I didn't know her. She didn't know me. We hadn't talked about. And I was like, what? She was like, something is going on with you. But I need you to understand, this is a physical manifestation of all the stuff, basically, that you tucked. You tuck and you keep going. Now, that had been going on for, how old are you, 24? 24 years. At that point, it became a whole different ball game for me. I wasn't afraid to die. I wasn't afraid. I was so focused on understanding myself, how to get past this, how to not let this happen again. And I remember in one of the exams, you know, I had to do all these scans. So you have to get an echo, and which is a exam for your heart. And in one of them, they put the ultrasound thing at your belly, and they scan up so they can just see, right, what's going on. And right on the screen, I saw my heart, but I also saw that thing sitting over my heart. And I was like, wow, I can see it. I can literally see it. And I started thinking of all the stuff that I never processed, that I never dealt with, that I just tucked and kept moving. And for a year and a half, 2 years, I was in my peace bubble. Not worried about this thing, right? But worried about this thing. To the point where I was like, all right, what are we doing today? Y'all might, you might have seen me somewhere and thought I was crazy because you think I'm talking to myself, but I'm not. I'm talking, but I'm listening. What are we doing today? Should I go here? Should I say that? Should I? It was like a whole different world. And when I got through it, everything was fine. They said, oh, you had a complete pathological response to this. We rarely see this. Everything's gone. I can't believe it was so small. Now it's completely gone. And if I'm being honest, I was a little bit sad that I was moving back into the world, right? Because my peace bubble was being tested. And I have to tell you, I'm still working on sometimes when I get in that go, go, go mode and I get ready to do stuff, I have to stop. Shh, quiet. To the point where I might lock myself in a room if I feel like it's too noisy. Because I need to hear, I need to understand this decision that I have to make, because I make a lot. Am I making it from the outside in or the inside out? And by that I mean, am I allowing external forces to drive me toward a decision? Or am I making this decision in here, listening, discussing, and then moving? Because I know that the reverse can kill you if you don't listen. And you can't hear if you're always talking. You can't hear if you refuse to hear, right? Because again, it's not gonna yell at you. It's not gonna say, you have to do this. It wasn't until I could not do anything but listen that I learned to listen. So that's my encouragement to y'all, especially, I know there are some men out here, but to the mothers, to the women, because we, as this virtuous woman, we do everything for everybody else. We're here, we're there, we're everywhere. And we're thinking that that will earn us the virtue. That's not how it works. You gotta be that already. And because you are that, you do those things. Not do those things, then you get the virtue. No. Because if you notice, somebody that, if we can agree, this lady, she don't sleep. She's always working. Any human will be depleted, right? If you're just doing it at the human level, like when the lady touched Jesus, he felt that virtue leave. If you're just doing all of that at the very natural level, you are going to be depleted. No human can sustain that. You gotta be the virtue. So that when all of the work is done and it's time to replenish, you can do that. And none of that stuff that she did earned her the virtue. None of it. Now, yes, do it, right? But you do it because that's who you are, not because that's who you're trying to be. And I can't tell you what that means for you. He can't tell you. You got to listen. Ask. Listen. He'll tell you. But please don't let it be the way it was with me. Because I figured I probably had, that might have been my last shot. Like, if she's not going to listen this time, she's out of here. And it wasn't until I realized I'm fighting so hard to be on this earth. Like, I'm fighting so hard in the work that I did, right? To make myself comfortable, my family comfortable, here, there, everywhere. Totally missing it. Totally missing this thing called life, living. Not really enjoying it. I hardly ever enjoyed it because I was always so busy. Always working, always here and there, and this event, that event. Really didn't enjoy it. But now I know why. Because some of them, I just shouldn't even been there. And if I had listened, I wouldn't have gone. So I'm not there, but I know where to go when I need to. And I'm still at the very rudimentary phase where I literally have to cut stuff off, cut people off so I can hear. Maybe one day, I always say, I'll be like my mom, who she can talk and listen at the same time. Right? But I'm not there yet. But I will tell you this, I'm willing to do whatever it takes, because I have to live from the inside out, not based on any of those things, none of that stuff, none of it, inside out. So that's my story. I thank y'all so much for listening. I thank you for having me. I want only the best for everybody. And I pray that you don't have to go through what I went through to get to where you need to be. So if you leave nothing with nothing else, just learn to listen. Learn to listen and don't chase the virtue. Be it. Thank you.
For you, before you take your seat, if you could just pray for all of the women who are here and those who are out there, and you all get a close up. To make it really personal, BR is going to pray for you.
I am. Father, we're here. I don't know who this was for. I know it's for me again. But I'm asking you to please speak to everyone here who is willing to listen. For those who haven't listened in the past, give them another chance. You gave me a chance. You don't respect people. You're not a respective person. Somebody here can have another chance. Whatever they're going through, help them to understand, to see that thing on their heart, on their mind, the way you allowed me to actually see it. One thing you know is that everyone in this room is at least willing to try. That's the mustard seed. They're here. Honor that. I trust you to do that. I've seen you do it. It's not a question about will you, can you. Allow them to let you. Even if it doesn't look like we thought it would look. Father, God, we love you. We know that this universe is yours. And we are here not to just learn how to stay here, but how to be what and who we will be for eternity, eternal spirits. I thank you for your kindness. I thank you for your love, for your faithfulness, for your sense of humor, for your ability to be there with every single one of us at the same time, all the time. I ask that you please spend some time, even with the small still voice, if you have to be a little louder with somebody today, I ask that you do that so that they understand that it's you. And I ask that in the name of your son, who you gave to us as an example of how to listen, how to go in the wilderness when you have to be quiet, how to subject the body to the mind and the spirit. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, let's give God praise. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Powerful. Wasn't that powerful? Amen. You may be seated. We thank God for that word. And we pray that God would seal it in your heart. We pray for B.R. Lane. We thank you, Father, for all that you have made her to be. We pray that you would refresh and restore her on today, as she's poured out to us, and that you would pour into her, and that you would continue to use her for your glory. In Jesus' name, bless her daughter in every way. Amen. Thank you so much. I've never preached that Proverbs 31 like that. So when you hear it, you can say that was B.R. Lane. That's good right there. And I hope that you were blessed. You have a book out yet? You don't have a book out yet. So what I want to do, I want our audio team to be sure that I get this audio, and we'll send it out, and we'll send the manuscript to you. That's how T.D. Jakes and them do it. People say, why they do it so fast? They take all the sermons and get them transcribed, and then of course you can look over it and add to it, because that's a whole book right there. Just a little bit you shared, and the things that you have done, the places you've been, gives us a snapshot of what God can do. And so many people would be blessed to be able to read that. And so we just gonna help with it. And so y'all make sure where Nikki at, because I don't want to forget this. Please be sure, Tasha, to make tumbling to make sure Nikki knows that I want to do that. All right? And we'll send you the manuscript. All right. If you want to be saved, raise your hand. I want to pray for you. You say, I want to be saved. I want to give my life to Jesus Christ. Oh, by the way, Pastor Tamiko, you can help me with this, because she has presented many authors. And so will you help with that? I guess if you would have said no, that would have looked just. I knew you would, but I just asked anyway. So, yeah, so we have everything we need to help you with that. And so then when you come back, we'll be able to do a book signing. Amen. Won't that be wonderful? People hear your story. And it's so powerful and it's so God, because B. R. Lane didn't know that our theme was the Holy Spirit. And she talked about the voice. If you listen. And the voice she's talking about is the voice of the Holy Spirit. So God did that. And yesterday the Holy Spirit was dealing with me on something. And to say to you, and as for me, as to say to you as well, so all of this just kind of goes together, that you are already who God made you to be. You already have your assignment. And so everything that happens in our lives helps prepare us to walk into that. Gideon, mighty man of valor, and he's hiding. When God finds him and calls him what he would be later, that he didn't know at that time that he was. And I love that message because it takes the pressure off. You're already who God wants you to be. Amen, amen. So many wonderful things in there. We're working so hard to stay here instead of just being here and enjoying it. Wow. Powerful. All right. Anybody want to be saved? Raise your hand. I want to pray for you. If you're not saved, and if you're out there watching the replay, or if you're watching now, all over the world, those of you who are watching in Poland, Pakistan, Australia, Cape Town, South Africa, Lagos, Nigeria, Australia, thank you for being with us. And please share this so that it goes all around the world. If you want to be filled with the Holy Spirit, raise your hand. I want to pray for you. Glory to God. If you'd like to join this church today, raise your hand. I want to pray for you. If you'd like to join this church today. And if you're online, if you want to join, be filled with the Holy Spirit, if you want to be saved, let us know and we'll follow up with you. All right. God be the glory. Let's give God one more praise. My mother is not here today. She's spending time with my sister, Latour, so she may be watching. And they took her out, Latour and her husband, for a wonderful time today. And my mother's enjoying herself. It is my understanding she got her first pedicure ever. And she got that pedicure. I'm a third generation Church of God in Christ. I grew up a Church of God in Christ too, so we have a connection there. And my mother has never had a pedicure. It was a sin. You get a pedicure, you're going to hell. That's enough to scare you right out the shop. And they told me she got a pedicure and she was going back and she wanted the same person to do it that was there. And then she was asking the young people to teach her how to do some kind of shoulder thing. It's like, you're talking about the same person, but I'm my mother. Ask you to teach her how to do a dance? I got concerned. I had to sit mama down for a little talk. She's texting me, using emoticons and stuff. I'm like, who is this? She's having the time of her life. And she's only in her 70s. So she could have the time of her life for another 20 plus years, the Lord willing. Amen? She'd probably tell you, don't wait that long. Enjoy yourself while you can. So we have a blessing for her. I'll make sure that she gets this. You give honor to whom honor is due. Honor is due her. Also, thank God for my daughter, who is the mother of my grandson, my only grandchild right now. I have four daughters and one grandchild. Isn't that amazing? In the 21st century, you got to wait. You got to wait on the Lord and be of good courage, because children come a little bit later sometimes. She's a mother, so happy Mother's Day to you. Let's give God praise for Lantra. and all of the mothers. We didn't do the presentation up front because there's a lot of women who and men who struggle because their mothers have gone on to be with the Lord. So we didn't want you to have to deal with that. There's some people that don't go to church when churches were open, won't go to church. Lots of people on Mother's Day because they really struggle with that. So, but we thank God most of all for the mother of my children. Amen. That's a really nice necklace she got on right there. Yeah, that's, isn't that something right there? And all the sparkly over there. Amen. Looking like a Mercedes Benz over there. Amen. The one with the wide body. Y'all know something about the wide body? No more. Brian about the okay. Anyway, so thank you for being a great mom, and I think that Pastor D is the quintessential example of that Proverbs 31, already virtuous. And I want y'all to remember that part. Sister Mary, that's a powerful piece. Already virtuous, because a lot of people, and in my mind and how we taught it and how I was taught, that you were a virtuous woman if you were all of this. And that's a lot to come up to. So that message needs to be taught all over America. And I'm asking God to open doors for you. Not to be busy necessarily, because you can kind of pick and choose, I'm sure, but people need to hear that, especially those in the church. So we have something for you. You can come this way, Brother Deacon Reggie, if you help her to navigate the stage there. That's for you. All right. Please stand. We're going to have Pastor D to dismiss us. I think that would be appropriate. Did you want to say something to us since you're here with your mom? Would you like to say something? We still got a microphone. We're going to give you a chance to say something. You traveled so far. Amen. Let's get, what's your name?
Cameron.
Let's welcome Cameron to Urban Prayer Church.
Hi, everyone. It's actually kind of funny that we're here today. A little bit random. I never thought that my mom would be doing this, even though we grew up in the church. My grandparents have a church. But what I do know is that everything happens for a reason. God's purpose works in mysterious ways. And whoever needed to hear my mom's testimony, I hope that they were able to receive it and it can be the first step to changing their life in the way that they need it to. So thank you, guys.
Bless you.
We bow our heads. Father God, we thank you for this day that you've blessed us to see. And thank you, Father God, for giving us mothers, Lord God, virtuous women of God who have raised and showed us, Lord God, the way that you would want us to live. And we thank you for your love, your kindness, and your blessings on today, Father God, that you are blessing each and every family represented here, not only in this sanctuary, but those who are viewing and those who's going to rewatch the tape as well, Father. And we thank you, Lord God, for your loving kindness, because you are our Father and our Mother, whatever we need, Lord God, in our lives, that you are doing that, and you are that for us, Father. We thank you for your love and kindness. We ask you to bless everyone as they go out on today, Lord God. Bless all the families, and may we continue, Lord God, to praise and give you worship and glory for all that you are. In Jesus' name, amen.
Traveling grace be with you. Peace to all of you in love with faith from God the Father. And we have gifts for all the moms on your way out. The Lord Jesus Christ, grace be with you all. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in sincerity, amen, and traveling grace be with you in good portion. My people.